Good morning, students. This is Raj Gajendra Pillai, Kana Kingdom. Today we will be learning about how to write an essay. On a particular topic. So, take out your notebooks, your pencils, be attentive. Let's start. Give me 5 seconds, take out your books. So now, let's see the table of contents. What all we are going to learn in essay writing. We will be knowing about what is essay. What are the contents? What contents are main in essay? We have the topic of my school today. So we will be looking at the pics. Identifying what all things are being done. According to that, we will write points on it. And the essay would be complete by the last slide, where you have to learn about particular points, what all comes vice versa. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So, in the 10 points, we have written an essay. Right? So now we look into what is essay. Essay is generally a piece of writing which you write that the author's own argument. Essay is generally a piece of writing that gives the author's own argument. If I am writing a story, it's a piece of writing and author is me. So now you understand who is author. If I am writing, I am the author. Author means the writer of the essay. But the definition is vague. When you talk about definition is vague, means it is not definite. It's like writing the views on the own views, own understanding, own facts and own knowledge. The same story written by different persons in a paper, in an article, in a pamphlet or a short story, all will overlap, like half of the story of this person, half of the story of this person. Concept same, but it varies from what is written by a person in paper or in an article or in a pamphlet or in a short story. All will be different, will be not definite. The theme comes, it will be all overlapped. Half of his story is correct, half of his story is correct on a same topic. So now, how does essay writing help kids? By inspiring them, by use their imaginations and motivates them to read more. Essay writing helps kids by inspiring them. What is inspiration? Inspiration is getting inspired by the stories of the athletes, the actors, the freedom fighters, the warriors. These are all inspirational stories. When you talk about inspiration, you get inspired by looking at the stories, how people go ahead, right? Inspire, they get inspired. Like Amitabh Bachchan is a very big actor. In the early stages, he was a struggling artist, right? He struggled and became a big artist now. He has reached the skies. He has reached to the top. He has become the top star. So, this is what inspiration means. Use of imaginations. Imaginations means imagine. Like you imaginate something of becoming, you will become that. If you imaginate about a story, imaginate about writing a good essay, about drawing a good essay, it widens your imagination and motivates. Motivates means you say, somebody says, you can do it. Yes, you can, you will do it. That's what is motivation. When we are able to perform and somebody tells us that you can learn, you can score first, you can come first in the class, you need to learn this, you need to learn the tables, the maths will be easy. Motivating is something like somebody telling us you can. यू विल, यू शुड, यू विल परफॉर्म, यू विल डू इट. सो एसे राइटिंग इज ऑल अबाउट इंस्पिरेशन, इमेजिनेशन, मोटिवेशन टू रीड मोर. इट इज ऑल्सो वन ऑफ द मोस्ट एंजॉयबल वे टू प्रैक्टिस ग्रामर, इम्प्रूव योर स्क्रिप्ट राइटिंग एंड स्पोकन इंग्लिश. राइट, तो नाउ लेट्स गो टू द एसे डायरेक्टली. नाउ सो नाउ यू कैन सी स्कूल टूडेज एसे, टूडेज एसे, वॉट इज टूडेज एसे, इट शोन माई स्कूल, एसे ऑन माई स्कूल. सो राइट इट डाउन, द टॉपिक इज एसे ऑन माई स्कूल. वेन यू टॉक अबाउट माई स्कूल, इट इज समथिंग यू आर राइटिंग ऑन योर ओन. द एसे, द कंटेंट्स इन इट, एसे कंटेंट्स विल बी रिटन बाई यू ऑन माई. वेन वी टॉक अबाउट माई, यू आर टॉकिंग अबाउट योर सेल्फ. सो वॉट ऑल यू फाइंड इन योर स्कूल अकॉर्डिंग टू यू, यू हैव टू राइट. राइट नाउ 5 seconds. टू स्टार्ट विथ एन एसे अबाउट माई स्कूल, वॉट यू विल स्टार्ट विथ, लुकिंग एट द टॉपिक ऑफ माई स्कूल. माई स्कूल स्टार्ट्स विथ द नेम फर्स्ट. फर्स्ट यू हैव टू राइट द नेम ऑफ योर स्कूल. सो वॉट इज योर स्कूल्स नेम? माई स्कूल्स नेम इज कान्हा किंगडम स्मार्ट एजुकेशन. वेन यू स्टार्ट राइटिंग एन एसे, योर टॉपिक शुड बी क्लियर एंड योर कंसेप्ट शुड बी क्लियर. वेन यू आर राइटिंग अबाउट स्कूल, यू टेल दैट वॉट इज योर स्कूल्स नेम फर्स्ट. When you talk elaborately about your school, you have an idea about school. So first of all, the topic starts with the name of the school. Your essay content starts with the name of the school. So you write about your school's name first. My school's name is Kana Kingdom. That is the first point which you have written of the essay. What all you see in the pictures, what all you see, you, whatever see in the clips, whenever you imagine as at a pic, a picture in your mind. Whenever you say something, this is my school. But if you write something about a day in a park, one day out, one day's picnic, what all imagination, you have started your picnic, where you have gone first. Which place you have reached, you have to write the topic from where you started, how you started. You have started from school, you took a bus, you reached at this place. When you reach at this place, you start writing that, okay, I have reached this place, this Junagadh. Or when you reach at some place, when you have some topic of essay, you start writing on it and start with the name first. Right? So now write down this point. Now after the point of the name introduction, now second what you are going to write? In which class you are studying. So second point you will write on your own, that I study in dash class in my school. In which class you are studying? First was your school's name, which comes to the mind when you talk about particular my school, my school's name. The second point is I study in dash class, in first class, in second class. I study in first or second class in my school. And what all you can see in the class? My classroom are big and airy. When you sit in the class, you are a good place. Your one table desk is here. The next is very far. You have fans, you have AC. You look into your classroom. What all the provision is been given? When you sit in the class, there are fans on the top, there are ACs. What do? You start in fan. When you open the windows from all the four sides, what comes? the air comes from inside, it's cool. When you sit, it's you have to mention how is the atmosphere there. Atmosphere means how you feel when you sit there. So my classrooms are very beautiful. When you say about beautiful, all your walls are well painted. You can see your boards on the front where the teachers writes, right? You can see, you can feel air which comes through the window. Fan is also started, which needed. Fan is there, it's airy. My classrooms are very beautiful and airy. Everything is clean, neat and tidy. What you say? I study in first class in my school. My school classrooms are very beautiful and airy. Right? So, you got your imagination about your school. My school's name, I study in first class. My school classrooms are very beautiful and airy. So these are the points to be noted. You have written 3 points now. Now let's go to the 4th point. Then you have written the points. It's beautiful and airy. Now what all your school has? So you are writing about particulars about the school, right? You will take a certain point. After the assemblies, where do you go? You go out for club time. So now you are going to write about your club time. My school has a big playground for students to play. What is it? Playground. What is a playground for? Playground is for playing. So what do students do there? What do you students do? So your students play. My school has a big playground for students to play. So you're writing that point where you say that my school has a big playground. What is that big playground for? It's for students to run and play. When you say students to play, everything comes in that. Your games, your running, your playing of khokho, your playing of kabaddi, just running one after another. This is all a set of plays where you play. So now you are writing, you have written one more point. So what is that point is? You are told about your school, you are told about your class, you are told about how beautiful and airy it is. Now your fourth point is my school has a big playground for students to play. So now write this point. So this is the fourth point of your essay where you have written my school has a big playground for students to play. Your school includes a big playground. So now my school, we are looking into what you can see in the front. It's a computer lab. When you talk about a computer lab, what is a computer lab? Computer lab is where it's a classroom. It's a big room where all the computers are kept for students to come and learn it. What we do? We use computers there. It's provided for one students each. A teacher is there who teaches about computers, basic about computers, what are computers, keyboards, how to operate, how to write and type your name. The first thing you learn is to how to write, how to type in computers. We use the computers with the presence of the teacher who teaches us about how to type and how to operate a computer. Basically, our computer lab, one student uses one. This is what our computer lab is for. It's for individual one student sitting in one computers learning about the basic of computers. This is a facility given, additional facility given for all the students from our school. So now moving ahead, after the computer lab, what is the point? There is a big library for students in our school to read books. What is a library? Library is a collection of good knowledgeable books about all topic, various topics. It has comedy books, it has studying books, it has literature, it has many things giving knowledge about anything and everything which you search for. It has thousands and thousands of books. In our school we have more than 1,000 books of various topics. What we do? We go to the library, we sit in the library, you can see on the pics where our school students are sitting. They are reading the books and knowledge about something. They are looking at the book, they are studying, they are more interested in learning by seeing at the books. They get more inspired about knowing something which they don't have in the regular class. In the regular class we have subjects. Leaving that subjects, if you go to library, you can find many things. A part of the topic, you can learn some inspirational stories. You can look on to some comics if you want for some entertainment. You have many things to learn. You have some good picks if you are very much interested in seeing new things. If you want to see some cultural things, some things where it shows more and many forts, something it shows museums. For girls, you can see Barbie doll book, Cinderella stories. There are many things which are very much interesting for small kids. When you go to the library, you find books where you go on turning pages, where you read something, whatever you like, you read, you try to find out what it is, right? So what is a library? And the big library, it is a collection of books where it gives knowledge of various topics. It gives a general knowledge more about the world. You can explore the entire world through books. So we have a big library for students in our school to read books, right? So you have written one more point about this. Please write it down. So now we are going to the next point, where it says your views about teachers. Our teachers are very talented and kind. When you say our teachers are very talented and kind, what is the talent in them? What are the teachers talented for? Teachers are talented in making you understand about the studies, in making you understand about small things which you don't know. They teach you about the ethics, they teach you about cleanliness, they teach you about the topics, they teach you how to behave, they teach you how to behave with elders, how to behave with the family, how to behave with the students who are sitting with you, not to fight, not to quarrel, how to ask permission for, how to go out, how to come, how to write, how to learn, how to speak, everything. What is the teacher talented for? Teachers are very talented in teaching us the day-to-day life, how to learn, how to write, how to venture the world, how you speak to them, and what all is to be done. The basic day-to-day things are taught by family and teacher. So our teacher is very much talented and kind. When you talk about kind, teachers are always kind to everybody in the class. All students are same to the teacher. Whether he is a boy or girl, all the students are the same for a teacher, because he teaches the same thing to all in a uniformity. He teaches everything on the board. He teaches everything by telling it, not to one. It's for all the students sitting in the class. It's for all the students. It's only one thing वन टॉपिक विच इज टॉट टू ऑल, हाउ टू बिहेव, वॉट ऑल इज टू बी डन, वॉट ऑल इज टू बी नॉट डन. सो नाउ वन मोर पॉइंट ऑफ माई स्कूल एसे इज आवर टीचर्स आर वेरी टैलेंटेड एंड काइंड. राइट इट डाउन. सो नाउ लेट्स लुक इन टू द पॉइंट ऑफ अवर स्कूल कंडक्ट्स कॉम्पिटिशन एंड वी पार्टिसिपेट इन क्विज कॉम्पिटिशन स्पीच डिबेट्स इन अवर स्कूल. वॉट इज दिस? दिस इज एन इम्पॉर्टेंट पार्ट वेर ऑल द स्टूडेंट्स टेक एक्टिव पार्ट. वॉट डज अवर स्कूल कंडक्ट्स? अवर स्कूल कंडक्ट्स कॉम्पिटिशंस. वॉट डज इट कंडक्ट्स? इट कंडक्ट्स क्विज कॉम्पिटिशंस, इट कंडक्ट्स स्पीच कॉम्पिटिशंस, इट कंडक्ट्स डिबेट्स इन अवर स्कूल्स. हु टेक्स द एक्टिव पार्ट्स? ऑल द स्टूडेंट टेक्स एक्टिव पार्ट इन ऑल द कॉम्पिटिशंस. अवर स्कूल कंडक्ट्स कॉम्पिटिशंस इन रिगार्ड्स टू आर्ट्स एंड क्राफ्ट्स, इन क्विज, इन स्पीच, इन डिबेट्स. There are various topics which are set by our school. So, where are these conducted? These are all conducted in auditorium. In our auditorium, all the students sit where more than 100 chairs are been provided, where they can sit, they can make their themes ready. If it is quiz, they sit and answer. The quiz competition is done in auditorium. The other competitions like speech, speaking, debates by the school, topics are given where we have to debate, where we have to speak our vocabularies, our language, what we know, we write it and we speak it. That is what our school conducts. So everybody takes active part in the school competitions, especially in quiz, speech, debates, cultural activities and many other activities which are being conducted, newspaper making, everything, right? So this is the main point where you have to write it about the competitions which are conducted by our school. So now the ninth point is my school teaches us good manners, ethics and cleanliness. What is ethics? What is good manners? What is cleanliness? My school teaches us. When you talk about school, it is all teachers. When you talk about school, all teachers of different subject teaches us what? Good manners. What are the good manners? You speak about good manners. When you want to enter, you ask the permission, you sit. Before sitting, you say thank you. When somebody helps you, you tell thank you. You use the words, magic words, please, thank you. So everything, it's a manner, it's a pattern way where you have been taught how people help and what you should be thankful to. Whenever there is a queue, you have to maintain the queue. It's a proper manner how you come to the school. One by one you have queued up, 1, 2, 3, 4, you queue it, you don't push or pull. These are the manners how to behave. When there are somebody talking to you, you should always listen properly. First listen, then talk. What are other manners? How you sit in your bench, how you make your poster sit, how do you write, how do you remove your book, how do you behave with your student who is studying with you, how is your classmate, how you behave with your classmate, how you talk to him, you should be polite. This is all what being taught as a manners. What are ethics? Ethics are what are the things to be done and what are the things to be not done. They are ethics. They are called as ethics. Ethics is to understand what is wrong and what is right. Ethics are the basic things which you have to follow. Manners is a different thing. Ethics is a different thing. Ethics are the thing made you understand that what is wrong एंड वॉट इज राइट. क्लीनलीनेस, क्लीनलीनेस मीन्स क्लीन. यू कैन सी द क्लासरूम हियर इन द पिक वेयर इट शोज ऑल द टेबल चेयर इज नीटली अरेंज्ड, एवरीथिंग इज क्लीन. सेम वे क्लीनलीनेस, इट्स कॉल्ड एज क्लीनलीनेस. हियर इज पोरिंग द सूप इन इट एंड सर्विंग सम फूड इज टेलिंग वॉट telling thank you. She is just ready for the soup and she is telling thank you. All right, so these are the habits, where these are the things which are being taught. These are the basic things: ethics and good manners and cleanliness. Cleanliness is next to godliness. That's what we say. You have to be clean. You touch something, what you do? You go wash your hands, you wash your face. What you do? Always, whenever you touch something, you wash your hands and clean it with handkerchief, using handkerchief. Always use handkerchief. So this is the basic thing which is been needed. So all these things are taught where? In our school, by set of teachers. All teachers teach you something or other. They teach you how to behave, they teach you how to learn, they teach you how to study. They teach you all the subjects which are unnecessary, right? So this was the 9 points. Write it down. My school teaches us good manners, ethics and cleanliness. So now, when I write about my school, I would say that my school is the best school in our city, Didwana, because here I have been taught the values of a student, a person. We have been taught, we have how to play, we have been taught how to study, we have been taught how to be competitive, we have been taught with good manners, good ethics, we have been taught with all the things which are needed. Computers also we have. We learn computers, we learn studies, we play, we do everything in our school. So our school is one of the best school in our city, Didwana. Now, write it down. So now, let's add one more line to the essay, my school. This is the conclusion of the essay. When we talk about conclusion, let's conclude means let's finish this. Let's write the last sentence and complete it. So now, when I talk about my school, I love my school. Why do I love? Because I enjoy studying here. Studying is the main thing in the school where I enjoy it. Apart of this, we have many things. We have other activities. We have cultural activities. We have computer lab. We have science lab. We have play stations. We have everything in our school. We take part in competition. We take part in debate. We take part in everything that is conducted by school. Quiz competitions we do. But moreover, everything, I love my school from my heart. When we say I love my school from my heart, because I enjoy studying here. So now it is coming from the heart. So now let's go with all points which I have been taught. Write this point down so that we can go through all the points which we have learned. So now we have seen all the pictures of the school. We have known about everything. Now let's go on the some lines of essay which we have written. So now I will repeat it. Once I tell, second time I will repeat. You have to write it down. I hope so you have written it down. So now, my school's name is Kana Kingdom Smart Education. My school's name is Kana Kingdom Smart Education. I study in dash class in my school. There you have to fill it. whatever class you are, you need to fill it. I study in dash class in my school. I study in dash class in my school. My school classrooms are very beautiful and airy. My school classrooms are very beautiful and airy. My school has a big playground for students to play. My school has a big playground for students to play. There is a computer lab in my school where we use computers. There is a computer lab in my school where we use computers. There is a big library for students in our school to read books. There is a big library for students in our school to read books. Our teachers are very talented and kind. Our teachers are very talented and kind. Our school conducts competitions and we participate in quiz competition, speech, debates in our school. Our school conducts competitions and we participate in quiz competition, speech, debates in our school. My school teaches us good manners, ethics, and cleanliness. My school teaches us good manner, ethics, and cleanliness. My school is the best school in our city. My school is the best school in our city. I love my school because I enjoy studying there. I love my school because I enjoy studying there. So now I hope everybody has written it and learned about essay, right? So how we have wrote essay? We have looked into all the pitch, we have known about our school, we wrote about our class, right? Now happy learning. Today we have learned about essay. Thanks.